As I mentioned in some previous videos of my channel, masking in CreateStudio Pro is working a little bit different than it used to in the previous CreateStudio software. So, I was thinking that you might want to know how to mask a character with text. Well, not really masking with text, but the character will come out from a letter, so it will look like it is masked with a text. Today's example will explain exactly that, so please watch till the end and discover two ways to do that character masking. Victor here with a new tutorial about how to mask a character in CreateStudio Pro, so let's just get started. I'll get a rectangle to have my background and I want this extended to fill the whole canvas. Next, I will need a text. I am typing create. And I want this to be bigger, like this. Now I will make a copy of this text and I will bring it down here, and for this one I type in Studio. The font I'm using for this example is Bebas Nui. I hope I pronounced correctly. I will change the color of the upper text to yellow. Now that I have my text set as I want, I need to go in Studio and I am searching for Michelle. And here she is. I just bring her on the canvas, right here over this text. I would want her smaller, just to fit the hole from the letter O. I am just rotating her to look like she's coming out from behind half the letter. She already has the wave action set, so I will just need to add a custom animation to have her coming out from below a little to the right. For the custom animation I will set position, and for easing I will go with the expo. For the starting point of the animation, having my playhead over the first keyframe, I will bring Michelle down here. Once I have the animation set as I want, I need to make sure I go on and group Michelle before I would want to mask her. After I have her in one group, I would need a mask for her, so I will bring in a rectangle. I'll set a green color for this one just to see it better, and I will resize this rectangle. For a better adjustment, I'll bring the opacity down a little bit to be able to see through. To have your corners rounded, you just grab one of these dots handles and adjust all four corners simultaneously. Very important for this masking is to make sure that the left edge of the mask is perfectly aligned with the inner edge of the letter O. If I hold shift and drag one of the handles, I will alter only that single corner. For a fine adjustment of the rounded corner, and to give you a tip about modifying a shape, I hold shift key, and if I bring my mouse here on the bottom edge of the rectangle and I click and drag slightly to the right or to the left, I can alter the shape of this rectangle. And now, if I rotate a little bit, I can fine adjust this mask to fit where I need it. Now, back to masking. As you can see here, the upper part of Michelle will be inside of the rectangle. And so, after masking, Michelle will only be visible within the boundaries of this green rectangle. Once I have Michelle animated and grouped, and the rectangle mask position in place, I can go on and select both and mask the group with the rectangle. And now I have Michelle mask coming out from the letter O. If I needed to go back and edit the mask, I just go and double click the character and the mask border is showing, so I can go in and further adjust the mask. To exit the mask, I just need to go and click on the side and the mask is closing back. So you can go on and adjust the masking to be perfect. This is only an example for you to get an idea on how to do that, and I won't take more of your time trying to make it perfect now. Let me show you another example of a character coming out from a letter or a text. I just go in Studio Library and I will look for Danny, and let's bring Danny on the canvas. The default action is wave, but I gonna need a different action for Danny. I will choose this skateboarding action for this animation example, and I go here to properties and flip Danny to face the other direction. I extend the action time duration here on the timeline, and I will also want my character to be smaller, to fit the letter D and O. So I will set scale at 19%. Once that I have the right size of my character, I go on and add some animations. I'll start by adding a position animation with a linear easing. With my playhead over the last keyframe, I will bring Danny right here like this. To move Danny furthermore, I will add another animation, same linear easing, but this time I will set a position and a scale animation. I want my character to scale up this time a little bit, to give the impression that he's coming towards the viewer. And again, I have my playhead over the last keyframe, and I will just bring Danny down here, but I will also go and change the scale value at 22%. I keep adding another position animation, same linear easing, and for the end position of this animation I will move my character slightly to the right. One more animation, same linear easing, and this will be once again position and scale. Now I'll bring him right here and set the scale value back to 19%. To get Danny to his final position, I will add one last animation. This time will be position and linear easing, and I'll bring him here to the right. Now I quickly grab each animation and drag them together one after another to have a smoother animation. We can see the animation slowly. Danny is coming here and going to the right. To create a mask for my character, I go here and activate the pen tool. And I zoom in, click here once, zoom back out, and go down here and zoom back in again to click right here. And going down, one more click, and one more. And now I zoom in here to the letter O, and a few more clicks to have my mask ready. And back to the first point, I will close the path shape I just created. I can zoom in here, and if I double click on the path border, I activate these two handles that will help me to create a Bezier curve. So, the shape is just perfect. I turn the border width to 0, and I'll bring the fill color opacity all the way up to 100. I'll just make it green to see the difference. Now I can go and group Danny, and let's name this after him. And I will also rename the shape I was just creating using the path tool, and I will call this one mask. I'll select both Danny and the mask, and I go on and mask Danny with the shape I just created. If I play my animation, you can see Danny is only visible where the shape mask was. I hope you find this tutorial helpful, and like always, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to be notified for the upcoming tutorials on my channel. Thank you for watching, and have fun creating!